Hi everyone, Pauline here. In this video, I want to welcome you to your fresh new Gitpod workspace. First, let's talk about the fact that this is a full-blown VS Code in the cloud. That's pretty amazing, right? Gitpod is a full Linux shell with a terminal. Now, I bet you're wondering, could I access root? And the answer to that is yes. You can use sudo to install additional packages that isn't included in the Gitpod base image. So just to show you, I'll install an additional package. Just to confirm, we don't have the package kause in our base image. As you can see, it says command not found. So let's install it together. Let's do a sudo apt-get install kause. And as you can see, it's installed it there. Press yes. Let's see if it works. Awesome, we can see the cow saying hello Gitpod. Once you're happy with this, you can actually add this to your workspace Docker file where these sorts of commands should go as part of your automation. If that wasn't cool enough, we also allow Docker and Docker Compose support. Gitpod has a default image, which is right here, gitpod/workspace-full. And that comes equipped with Docker. And so you can just use Docker CLI as usual. You can run and build Docker images to start containers in your workspace. That's pretty cool. Let's get you comfortable with the rest of the Gitpod workspace. Gitpod actually backs up the state of the workspace folder in between workspace starts so that you can revisit them later. And just to note, other files saved in different locations will not be saved. So just bear that in mind. Now, I just wanted to show you around the Gitpod dashboard. And so if you go on gitpod.io/workspaces, you can see this is where you'll see all your active workspaces. Right now, I've got my Svelte Playground open. And if you click on the three little dots, you can do all sorts of different things to your workspace. You can open it, you can stop it, you can download it, you can share it with other people. Sharing is something that I talk a bit more about in a later video. And you can also pin your workspaces. What this means is usually old and unused workspaces are automatically deleted. And so if you want to prevent that workspace that you're working on from being deleted, you have to make sure that you can pin it. Pinned workspaces are actually kept forever. If you want to keep that specific workspace running for as long as you want, make sure you pin it. Other things that you can do in the dashboard is create a new workspace directly. And we also have a list of examples just in case you want to play around with all these different options. Other things you can do is go into settings and just go through your account settings, email notifications, what plans you're on. If you have a team, you can manage it on here. You can also create environment variables and go through your Git providers and change your preferences. You also have access to our docs and our community directly from your Gitpod dashboard. I hope that you enjoyed this video. In the next video, I'll talk to you about fully automating your Gitpod setup.